Oh, what's going on? What the heck? What was that? Now it's daytime? And my rabbi is still with me. What was that? Is that gonna happen again? There's nothing around. Is this it? No, that's not it yet. Unless this is a village and he's deep inside the village. Don't go yet, don't go yet. Please don't go yet. Friend or foe? I don't see any weapon in your hand.
Ho there, friend. What are you doing out here at this time of day? In a few hours, the Bone Rippers will come out of their caves. And unless you're eager to meet one in person, you should see to it that you're far from here when that happens.
Do they only come out during the day? Or is night about to fall? Bone Rippers?
What? You made it all the way here without ever seeing one of them. Lucky you.
Well, I saw one, but before.
They are beasts. As big as trolls and as swift as tigers. They sleep through most of the day, but at dusk they usually come out to look for prey. And, unfortunately, they have gotten a taste for human flesh.
Hmm. Well, we walked here through the night. Didn't see any. Which I'm thankful for. Actually, I wasn't planning to stay here for long, but I'm looking for a small village. Silvergrove. Have you ever heard of it?
Heard of it? I guess you could say that. Behind these gates is the Valley of Silvergrove, and... You know what? Actually, I was just about to close the gate for the night. But if you're looking for our village anyway, why don't you just come in? I won't open them again until tomorrow noon, but that should be enough time for you to finish whatever business you have here. My Dame Thalar's banana grog is a blast, if that helps you decide.
Banana grog. Wait, so you're just gonna let me into your village? Isn't that a little careless? I mean, you don't know me at all.
Is it? I think trust has to start somewhere, doesn't it? And I've got a good gut feeling about you. That has to be enough for starters.
Fair enough, then. I'll come. Lead the way. Still wondering what made me pass out back there.
Glad to hear it. Follow me!
I wasn't saying that out loud, but... Don't mind my weird friend back there. Oh. Well, I can't move. Guys.
Then, here we are. We'll find a village if you just follow that road down there. At least to the grove. You can hardly miss it. It's a really nice place. I bet you'll like it there. Since that boy found the silver vein in the grove, we live like the Lightborn do in Inadan, really. So I guess this is farewell, isn't it? Unless you have questions.
Of course I have questions. I do, actually. You mentioned a boy who found a silver vein?
Well, you know. Silvergrove wasn't always as nice a place as it is now. Back in the old days, it was quite harsh, actually. But then, some traveler came by and left us with a small boy. He had a terrible disease, and I suppose that's why the guy just abandoned him.
Dalgeist.
I don't know how someone can be that heartless, but it was probably for the best. Ulbar adopted him, and... when exactly was that? 4 years ago, the boy found a silver vein while he was playing in a small cave near the grove. And, well... from then on, the wealth just flowed in pretty much by itself. Come to think of it, I don't want to imagine what this place would be like without the little fella. His name is Rhinaeus, or at least, that was the name stitched on the blanket that stranger left him with. Who knows? Maybe you'll see him for yourself. He's quite popular.
Rhinaeus. Interesting. What about this disease you were talking about?
I'm no apothecarius, but he had these tumors all over his face. And his left leg was entirely crippled. But just a few moons after Ulbar took him in, he started getting better.
Really?
The weather, maybe? I don't know. But I'm glad it happened. That boy is a treasure. Anything else? Otherwise, I'm damn ready for a nap.
Yeah. So see, I wonder if he looks like a, quote-unquote normal person at this point. I was under the impression he was born like that, and that was just, you know, the way he was born. One more thing. I had this kind of, headache, passed out, when I entered the valley. Any ideas what could have caused that?
A headache? Nah, sorry. Could be the heat. Maybe you were just thirsty.
No.
I wouldn't worry too much about it if I were you. Any more questions?
Quite a lot of time passed out. Quite a lot of time passed by while I was passed out. Yeah, I don't, think it was anything like that, and it wasn't a headache. No, but... Okay, that'll be all. Thanks for your hospitality, sir.
Ah, don't mention it. Walk blessed.
Ah, oh, you made it through. New keys for all these. Can't climb that. So this is not the city or the village yet? Well, if I wanted to get out, I could just jump over that. Good to know. Going up. Eight coins. You bet I'm gonna look all over. Oh, wow. These guys have a cannon. Maybe that was gunpowder. Wait, how do I get down? Okay. So I guess it's safe here. I don't know why you make that noise. Potion of might. Who is seeing me? I know it's not him. Don't see me right now. Blueprints! A filled common soul gem, 21 coins. Oh, special stuff. Sword of the Righteous Path. It's heavy, I'll leave it. Yeah, I don't need the stuff. Scene right after that. Oh, that thing's seeing me. That ladder's gonna lead us up right near it. it's hiding. I see you. Show yourself. I was about to go up, but then you showed yourself. Where is it? Did it fall? Hello, my friend. Oh, wrong thing. Well, that's okay. Just got friends anyway. Oh. I thought we were safe up here, what the hell? I figured this was a place where they cleared out all the nasty creatures. Locked them up. Oh, I'm like, what the hell was hanging down? I thought it was somebody's leg. Human over here. Oh, Tyarge pelt. Lots of things could be hiding in this long grass. Old silver like rats. Wow. Wait, my sound. Okay. Something weird happened with the sound there. Frame rate hits. Scroll of paralysis, cheap. I don't know. Should we go in the mine or should we head out? Keep heading to our destination. I don't want either of those things. I was trying to open the chest. Hammer. The shovel we need. A pickaxe. Oh, jeez. Old silver mine. Sure, I guess. We're right here. Oh, it requires a key. Never mind. Am I gonna pass out again soon? Hope not. So who is he keeping out? Just people? But monsters can hang out in here. Okay, so they gotta work on optimizing this place next. Hello, goat. Oh, I'm sneaking. Wow. It's a bad frame right here. Can I even jump up here? Okay. Alright guys, I know this probably looks like crap. Greetings.
Watch yourself. The streets aren't safe this time of the day.
You say something I heard other villagers say in the exact same tone of voice. Oh, there's a nice statue over there. Hello?
Walk blessed.
Why, thank you.
Reneas has the greatest father in the whole world. Sometimes I'm really jealous.
Don't be that jealous. His real father is not great at all.
I'm gonna be an adventurer, and I'm gonna explore the entire world.
That'll take quite a bit, quite a long time.
Walk blessed. Of course, take your time.
Okay, I will. I don't want any of this stuff, sorry.
May his light guide you. Maybe she would like that.
Who's she? His light will guide me, but she will like that. Oh. Oops. A nice statue. I wonder who this is supposed to be. Silvergrove Warehouse? Oh, this is, danger. Wow. I'm getting better at killing rats, I must say. Still a steal, though, even though... 8 coins? All that was just 8 coins. There's more in the chest. I come to steal your coconuts. $45 here. Oh, this is it? This goes back out? That's empty. Well. If anyone needed a rat killed in the warehouse, I done killed it.
Greetings.
Hello. Your town has terrible frame rate, I'm sad to say. Get good, will ya? 20 frames a second. Oh, now Silvergrove is discovered. Reneas's house, right there. Samuel?
More blessed. You're not from around here, are you? I don't think I've seen you here before.
You're talking in my right ear. No, I'm from the outside. Could you by chance help me to find my way around here as I turn slowly towards you?
You're welcome. What would this world be like without people helping one another?
That's not what you said there. Do you know of any places around here that are worthwhile for an adventurer?
You could take a look at the ruin near the oasis, or the one on the beach. That is, if you know how to fight off the wild animals around there.
Kinda.
But I don't know, do you really think that's a good idea, risking your life for some filthy lucre? I don't know.
Not questioning that myself, but I'm looking for a place to buy equipment, armor, weapons, and such.
Merchant. I take it you've already seen the Silent Moon's Inn.
Nope.
Tahara probably can't offer you more than provisions, but I'm sure she won't say no if you're looking to sell. Then there's Robach and his little ship on the outskirts of the village. And finally, Oliel in the marketplace. Not much, I know, but we don't get visitors here very often.
I've met Oliel. Do you happen to know where I can find a boy named Reneas? I was told he lives here. But yet I think his house is right behind me.
Reneas? Of course I do. A great lad, really. Did you know we owe all of our wealth to him? Without him, this place would be nothing. I'm rambling again. If you're looking for him, he and his father live on the next-to-last house on the cliffside of the village.
Which I think is right behind us. Well, thanks for your time.
You're welcome. What would this world be like without people helping one another? Take care and enjoy your stay here. You'll see. This is a beautiful spot on Earth we have here. It really is.
Or walk blessed. Well, we're right here. I guess we'll meet him. Wonder what he looks like. Oh my god. I still look like me. Why is he called Daddy? Like the daddy from my dream or other life or something? Yep. That's him, all right. Hello?
What? Who are you? Can I help you?
What the... Father?
I beg your pardon?
Nothing. It's just you look like somebody that I knew.
Okay, that's interesting. But, well, what is life but a sequence of weird coincidences? How can I help you? I don't think I've seen you around here before.
I'm looking for a boy named Reneas. I take it you're his father?
Foster father. But yes, I am. Why do you ask? Do you know Reneas?
No, not personally, but I need to speak with him. It's urgent.
Is it? Well then, be my guest. His room is just through that door over there. I think he's reading at the moment, but he always likes company.
Which door? I see. What's your story? How come you took him in? Life in these parts of Enderal must be harsh, even without a child to take care of.
You sure ask a lot of questions, my dame.
He's creeping
but
me
okay,
out.
But okay, why not? You know, I'm a widower. My companion and I always wanted to have a foster kid before Reneas. But as you said, life here was harsh, especially before Reneas discovered the silver veins. Frankly, we barely had enough to eat ourselves, and there weren't exactly a lot of orphans around here to take in either. Well, when my companion died, I was occupied with my thoughts, as you can imagine. Flesh maggots. There was nothing I or the apothecary could do for him. And Reneas appeared out of nowhere, discarded like a blunt knife. I saw him and how could I just leave him there? What kind of person could? It was demanding at first, to say the least, especially with his condition. But even then, I never regretted it, not for a second. Maybe it's a way of honoring the memory of my companion. I don't know. In any case, I'm glad it all happened like it did. Here in Silvergrove, we are all one big happy family. And every day, I can feel how happy Reneas is, knowing that we all accept him and love him, no matter what.
I just want to let everyone know that I'm really creeped out right now. Do you like meat? Can't help but think. In another eventuality, he was my father. And I was not me. I was someone else. Again, guys, don't tell me yes or no. Just talking out loud. So you're just gonna let me... You're gonna let a complete stranger roam through your house. People around here sure are trusting.
Yes, maybe we are. But, you know... Trust has to start somewhere, and in my experience, it is always rewarded. We have never had any problems with new people in Silvergrove. Never. And I have a hunch that's not about to change now.
Well, there's always the first time. Well, thank you. And one more thing, is it true that Reneas recovered from his disease?
Well... You sure know a lot about my boy, considering that you've never seen him before. But yes, it's true. He's as healthy as a horse, and has been for quite some time now. For some reason, those tumors he had started healing shortly after he arrived here. And no, I don't know why. And frankly, I'm not sure I want to. Some questions are better left unasked, as the saying goes. But you know what? Even if that miracle hadn't happened, it wouldn't have made a difference. Not here in Silvergrove. We would never have abandoned him like the ones who brought him here did. Reneas has a good heart, and that's all that matters.
Well, that's good to hear. Some meat, dead chickens. I mean, by itself, that's not that unusual. It didn't say which door. Banana liquor. Brother. I guess it's not this door. The disciplines of magic entropy. Interesting how you have an entropy book in here. That's a basket? What kind of basket is that? Blank paper. Butterfly in a jar. Oh, the dog sees us at the very least. Reneas?